I've been making YouTube videos for over a year now, and since I use a lot of iPhone footage in my videos, one of my biggest frustrations has always been moving files off of my iPhone and onto my Windows PC, which is where I do my editing in DaVinci Resolve. Now, if you clicked on this video, you can probably relate to this issue. There are a bunch of different ways to transfer files from iPhone to PC, but almost all of them are either slow, unreliable, or just troublesome at best. But a couple of months ago, I came across a Reddit thread that talked about this cross-platform AirDrop alternative called LocalSend, and ever since I started using it, I can't imagine doing it any other way. It's just so much smoother and faster than all the methods I've tried in the past. So let me give you a quick demo showing you just how easy it is to use. Okay, so I've got LocalSend open on my Windows, and I'm going to launch it on my iPhone. Going to go to the media picker and select a bunch of files that I want to send over to my PC. So I've selected 24 files, and as you can see in the nearby devices list, my Windows PC has already been detected because it's on the same home network. So I'm just going to tap that, and then I get a notification on my Windows saying that my iPhone wants to send you 24 files. So I'm going to accept that. And as you can see, the file transfer has begun. And as you can see, I'm getting a pretty good speed, around 24.5 megabytes per second. This really depends on the quality of your home network. So in my previous place, I was getting much slower speeds, but now things are very fast. So the transfer's finished, and then I'm just going to select done on both of them. And my files should be in my downloads folder. So, yep, these are all the files I just sent over. Now that you've seen the demo, let's talk about what you need for LocalSend to work. First of all, each device needs LocalSend installed. Unlike AirDrop, which lets you easily AirDrop something over to any other Apple device, with LocalSend you'll need to have it installed and running on the two devices before initiating a transfer. Secondly, each device needs to be connected to the same network. So since I usually do these file transfers when I'm at home, each device is already connected to the same home network, and it's never been a problem. But just keep in mind, it is different from Apple's AirDrop, which establishes a temporary ad hoc wireless connection between Apple devices for the transfer, and means you don't need to be connected to the same network. Now, you may have noticed that in the demo, I was having to manually tap each file I wanted to send in the media picker. This is fine for a small number of files, but it can be quite time consuming if you want to send tens or maybe even hundreds of files. This is a feature that I believe is being worked on, but it hasn't been implemented yet. There is, however, one way you can achieve this, which is to use the Photos app instead. So let me show you how this method works. Okay, so this time instead of using LocalSend, I'm going to open the Photos app. And just as you normally do in this app, you can select multiple items like this, and I'm going to hit the share button. Now, if I try sending with if I try sharing with LocalSend like this, iOS does this annoying thing where it tries to transcode the files for compatibility. And what that means is you're going to see this preparing spinner for a long, long time. So I'm going to cancel that. So the way to work around this is to instead of go to options up here, and in under format, select current. And this bypasses the preparing stage and just shares the original files. And then now I can share with LocalSend and it's instant. And just as I did before, I'm going to press the Windows PC and accept it on my desktop. To compare LocalSend speed with AirDrop, I also timed the transfer of the same 24 files from the first demo to my M1 MacBook Air. AirDrop completed the transfer in 38 seconds with a speed of around 32 megabytes per second. LocalSend took a bit longer, 48 seconds with a speed of around 25 megabytes per second. Of course, this will vary depending on your local network. And while it can't quite match AirDrop speed, I found it strikes the best balance between convenience and performance when transferring files across different platforms.